there's a rustling in the bush, and they cautiously go to look. And bang, 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 the gunshots rang through the valley, and a deafening silence. This shocking violence against the Aboriginal families occurred across Australia too many times. In the next 3 minutes, I will tell you a little of what happened and how we can acknowledge it. This story, the story of an attempted genocide, has been referred to as the whispering in the bottom of our hearts. Did you know that in Australia there are at least 270 recorded Aboriginal massacres in 140 years? In 1 year, there could be up to 8 massacres in one area of Australia, each taking about 10 lives and injuring 5. The estimated death toll exceeded 100,000. Only one of all of these were punished. Following the 1838 Mile Creek Massacre, 7 of the killers were hung. Because the Aboriginals had lost their land, food during this time was scarce. And when they were desperate, they resorted to killing settlers' livestock. Settlers and soldiers retaliated with deadly consequences. The British knew that the Aboriginals were hungry, so they put out bread poisoned with strychnine, and it took many lives. The British turned other Aboriginals against each other by promising a home and society, money and food. These special police were referred to as the Native Police and were also involved in some attacks. The killings happened because, just like the Aboriginals, the white people were bound in chains. These were not physical ones, but mental ones, locking away the truth and stopping them from getting to it. The truth that there were people on this land, and terra nullius, meaning uninhabited land, was a lie. Until recently in schools, people were taught that the British came and gave Aboriginals food, medicine, and houses. It would have been like being in a room with only one window, only one perspective to see through, when there's a whole different world, a whole different story to see. These are unforgivable acts. We can try to recognise them and move forward with our relationship with these people by firstly addressing the intergenerational trauma caused from these acts. With trauma comes very poor health, which can affect your life expectancy by up to 10 years. Education will also be affected, which may lead to poverty and jail from bad decisions. It will be a struggle to close the gap between regular people and traumatised ones. We must also learn from others' mistakes throughout history to treat people the same no matter what. Unlike the British to the Aboriginals or Hitler to the Jews, we must acknowledge people who called this land home 60,000 years ago. You may think this doesn't concern you because you moved here from another country, or since you didn't do it, it doesn't matter. But we are using this land, and by being citizens here, we are taking on the history of this country many call home. Only by recognising the truth of how we came to be who we are can we move forward and make decisions as a country on who we want to be as a community. Thank you.
Yeah.